All right, guys. So we got the simulator open right now. We just bought some 235 calls on NVIDIA at $1.67. And what I'm going to do here, guys, in this video using the simulator is walk you through a trade that I took a few days ago and give you the thought process, the preparation, the key levels and the game plan behind the trade, just to give you guys some good insights into how you should be going about preparing for any kind of trade you're taking. So let us pause this real quick and let's look at a few different reasons why we decided to trade NVIDIA this morning, what the key level of support was, the entry plan, what we were looking for on the tape, as well as our target for taking profits. So let's jump into this and let's break down this trade on NVIDIA, which returned about 60% in 3 to 4 minutes. Okay, guys, so for those of you that are in the Focus Trades group, if you watched the live stream that morning, you will remember the game plan here. But heading into the morning of the 31st, guys, NVIDIA, as well as the other semiconductor stocks, had a potential catalyst behind them. Heading into the open, semi stocks received upgrades before the open, and for intraday trades, upgrades and downgrades can really be nice catalysts, guys. They can really add some fuel to the fire to your long idea or to your short idea. So we wake up, we get some upgrades on semiconductor stocks. We're looking for a positive reaction in the semis, like NVIDIA, like AMD. I personally decided to put together a game plan for NVIDIA, and that was the focus. So game plan here at the open was to look for NVIDIA to hold above the pre-market level of support we identified at 221. So rather than just focusing on the candlesticks itself, what I really wanted to see was the bids holding above 221 and eventually beginning to lift a little bit higher. So if the bids could hold above 221 and the stock started to move, what I was going to look for was above average volume on the 15-minute time frame. If we could confirm on the tape that we had strength above 221, if it looked like we had some good volume coming out of the open there, the game plan was to take some entries in the weekly calls. So my game plan here, guys, and this is what I'm a fan of, keeping my losses small. If I'm taking an entry above 221, if the tape confirms before my entry that we're holding above 221, if at any point we're dropping below that level hard, I'm taking that position off for a loss. And as far as a target, we got that move above 221, if the bids held up, if the volume came in and we take our entry, where are we looking to take profits? And for a lot of options traders or just traders in general, this is where you tend to run into problems, right? A lot of that emotional bullshit tends to come up when we're thinking about, do we take profits here? Do I hold on for a little bit more? Am I leaving some on the table? Yada, yada. What we focus on in the Focus Trades group for any day trading, guys, is we tend to look to take profits near the full ATR. ATR is the average true range. That gives us an indication of how much the stock's moving up and down over the past 2 weeks. So for NVIDIA here, based upon where it closed on the 30th, a full ATR move, the average move this thing's making as of late, would have been a move towards 235.5. 236. We like to trade the average move. That's typically the easy trade. So the game plan here as far as taking profits and an exit is if we quickly approached that ATR level or if we approach the ATR level at any point during the day. So I will show you guys an entry and exit here on Tasty Trades towards the end of the video, but took the entry in the 235 calls 3 minutes after the open at $1.67 a pop. And as it quickly made a move about 3-4 minutes later towards that ATR, sold them for 264. That's a 58% gain. Let's go take a look at the chart now. All right, guys. So you can see that I did buy the calls on the simulator here. I bought the same calls that I bought in real time on the 31st. I actually got filled at the same price. So jumped into the 235 calls at $1.67 a piece. And what we saw here early in the open, right, initially was a quick move below 231, but very quickly the bids came in, the buyers came in, they got it back above that level, and they continued to accumulate NVIDIA above that key level of support. Also, guys, we take a look here at the 15-minute chart. One of the things we wanted to look for was a good little volume bar. We got that here. We got above average volume on the first 15-minute bar there. So we got our entry. We know at this point, if this thing reverses and drops below 231, we're taking the position off, no questions asked, and getting the hell out of there for a small loss, moving on to the next one. More importantly, though, if this thing begins to work in my favor, where am I looking to take this off? The average move for NVIDIA right now would be about a move up towards 235.5, 236. So no questions asked, guys. That was the game plan here. We start heading towards 235.50. We're looking to sell into strength. We're taking those gains there. That's the average move. Anything above that is going to be an above average move. And though a stock can definitely make that above average move with a catalyst behind it, I like to take the easy move. So my exit, guys, came, let's see here, about a minute from this point. So what I hope you guys have taken so far from this video was that we're not just blindly jumping into trades. We're focusing on certain names for a good reason. They're leading names, and especially on a morning like this, a leading name gets a catalyst. That deserves a spot on our watch list. I hope you guys are seeing the preparation behind it as far as why are we looking to trade this? What do we need to see on the tape before taking an entry? If we take an entry, where are we wrong? Where is our exit? If the trade works in our favor, where are we looking to take profits? What we're trying to do is if-then statements, and we're trying to make all of our trade decisions, guys, before the market even opens. This is what I love about trades, and more importantly, trade review, is that for those in the live stream that morning, we walked through this entire game plan here. The support level, what we had to see on the tape, every detail of this trade we laid out before we even, you know, got the opening bell. So it's gratifying to identify all those things. We're up early working hard, and then everything unfolds. So it was right about, guys, at this point, I believe, let me see, right, 9:36 in the morning. It was about this point right here, guys, where we came in and took those profits off the table there. So we'll see what price we can get fill at here. 244, and I truly got out at 264. So on the simulator, left a few cents there on the table, but nonetheless, guys, the entry was for a reason. The tape proved something to us early out the gate. We focused on NVIDIA not only because it's been a strong name as of late, but because of a shitload of options flow and the upgrades that morning before the open. We knew we were looking to take profits, and now if we can look at, you know, say, a few hours later, did we leave money on the table with NVIDIA? And remind you guys, a stock is going to make a bigger than ATR move every now and then. But typically, that's going to be the meat of the move, and it's going to be the easy trade. Oftentimes, something will run right up towards the ATR, just like NVIDIA happened to do here, and then begin that fade. Maybe it breaks the ATR later, maybe it never does, but if you've been trading options long enough, you understand the impact that a pullback like this can have against your options contracts, especially if you're trading the weeklies, right? So that's 12 o'clock there. If we go fast forward to the close here, right, if we see if NVIDIA ever made it bigger than the ATR move, right, that move that I took, the move that I think a few of us in the chat room took there, guys, that was the easy move. And, you know, you can sit here and you can have that conversation. Can I hold on for more, right? Am I leaving more on the table? More, more, more. Going for more is going to get you in trouble. You need to understand the significance of the ATR as a day trader. Build your trading business, if you're a day trader, around what happens most, right? High probability move is the average move. Anything above a stock's ATR is an above average day. And though that can happen with a catalyst or just a big market-wide move, what's the average move going to be? It's going to be that average move. If you can catch 70, 80, 90% of a stock's ATR, you're going to make more than enough money. As you guys can see, this was a 3-4 minute trade that made just under 60%. You don't really need to be getting into massive position sizes for returns like that to make a big difference at the end of the month. So I hope you guys took some value from this video. For those of you guys in the Focus Trades group, I'll see you bright and early tomorrow morning for our pre-market live stream. And we'll probably trade the first hour live tomorrow, considering everything going on in the market right now. For those of you guys not in the group yet, you can check out the link in the description, and I will see you all in the next video.